shake hands for first.
Ni kan ju gå och gå och prata där och
ha det så.
Tack så mycket.
Good morning. The Secretary General and the Prime Minister will deliver short remarks, and then we'll have time for a few questions. Secretary General.
Prime Minister Kristersson, dear Ulf, it is an honor to welcome you today to the NATO headquarters, because this is truly an historic day. In a few moments, we will raise the Swedish flag here at the NATO headquarters and all over the alliance, and welcome your country as the 32nd member of NATO. Sweden has taken its rightful place at NATO's table under the shield of Article 5 protection, the ultimate guarantee of our freedom and security. All for one and one for all. Joining NATO is good for Sweden. Good for the stability in the north, and good for the security of our whole alliance. Sweden has long been a partner. Now you are an ally, with all the benefits and responsibilities that this brings. Sweden has cutting-edge capabilities, first-class armed forces and defense industry, and spends more than 2% of GDP on defense. As we speak, Swedish troops are taking part in Steadfast Defender, NATO's biggest military exercise since the Cold War, a demonstration of our unity and our resolve. In response to Russia's war aggression against Ukraine, NATO has substantially increased our presence across the alliance. And Sweden's membership enhances this even further. When President Putin launched his full-scale invasion 2 years ago, he wanted less NATO and more control over his neighbors. He wanted to destroy Ukraine as a sovereign state. But he failed. NATO is bigger and stronger. Ukraine is closer to NATO membership than ever before. And as the brave Ukrainian continues to fight for the freedom, we stand by their side. Allies continue to announce billions of dollars in new aid, including Sweden's largest package yet, covering ammunition, air defenses, and combat boats. Our support to Ukraine saves lives, and it must continue. President Putin started this war, and he could end it today. But Ukraine does not have this option. Surrender is not peace. We must continue to strengthen Ukraine, to show President Putin that he will not get what he wants on the battlefield, but must sit down and negotiate a solution where Ukraine is recognized and prevails as a sovereign, independent nation. So, Prime Minister Kristersson, thank you for your personal leadership. Broad support across the political spectrum in Sweden has made this day possible. After more than 200 years of neutrality, you are joining the strongest and most successful military alliance in history. So, welcome to NATO. It's great to have you here.
Thank you so much, Secretary General, dear Jens. Thanks for welcoming us here today in many senses. Sweden is now part of NATO. We are a proud member together with our closest friends and partners. But first of all, Jens, I have to say thank you so much for doing this journey with us and for us. I have highly valued our close cooperation. Actually, from our very first meeting at Folk och Försvar, as we say in Swedish, the security conference in Sälen back in 2018, over many meetings and phone calls leading us here today. Without your tireless support and personal commitment, we wouldn't be here. I realize that you would have made the same effort for any qualified country applying for membership. But if you wanted us to feel that we were special, to you. You really did succeed. Thanks also to all NATO allies who have supported our accession and welcoming Sweden as the 32nd member of the alliance. We are humble, but we are also proud. We know the expectations for Sweden are high, but we also have high expectations for ourselves. The Swedish flag will raise here at the NATO headquarters today with a very strong support in our parliament and among our people. An important symbol for this is the fact that the Swedish delegation today consists not only by cabinet ministers and the commander-in-chief, but also by Her Royal Highness the Swedish Crown Princess Victoria and altogether six party leaders. In a vibrant democracy, we argue and we debate, but we unite in the long-term protection of this precious democracy. Unity and solidarity will be Sweden's guiding lights as a NATO member. We will share burdens, responsibilities, and risks with our allies. The security situation in our region has not been this serious since the Second World War, and Russia will stay a threat to Euro-Atlantic security for a foreseeable future. It was in this light Sweden applied to join the NATO Defence Alliance to gain security, but also to provide security. Our support to Ukraine is a fundamental part of that. Ukraine is fighting bravely for its own freedom, but also defending European freedom. In Sweden, we like to say and think we have unique military capabilities to contribute on land, in the air, and at sea. We are strengthening our defense and we are doubling the defense budget. From now on, Sweden meets the NATO standard of 2% of GDP to defense spendings. We have been prepared, honestly, for this task for quite a while. In reality, for the last 30 years. But more in details, the last 2 years. I am very pleased we have taken this final step today. Our country has long been a strong voice for international law, human rights, democracy and freedom, at home and abroad. With the Swedish flag being raised here today, we are clearly saying that we stand shoulder to shoulder in defending democracy and freedom together. We have come home, home to the Alliance for Peace and Freedom, to which so many democracies already belong, home to where we also belong. Now we are entering a new era. We will transform from following NATO to being NATO. I do look forward to this important task. Thank you so much.
Time for some questions. We'll start with Swedish radio here in the middle, please.
You have said over and over again that this has been a quick process, but still it's taken more time and been more difficult than most people expected. So I would like to ask you to be a bit more personal, maybe, if you can share your emotions. How does it really feel now to finally see the Swedish flag here at NATO headquarters?
This is a great day and an historic day. It's important for Sweden, it's important for NATO, but it's also important for me personally, because the Prime Minister is right that Sweden is special for me. Partly because Sweden for so many years have been such a close partner, but also because as a Norwegian, of course, I'm a neighbor and I have followed Sweden closely for many, many years. And when I started as Secretary General of NATO back in 2014, I was aware that some countries in Europe were applying for membership, countries like Montenegro and North Macedonia, and I'm very honored to be the Secretary General that has facilitated the membership for these two countries. But I didn't expect at all that Finland and Sweden was going to be a member during my tenure as Secretary General of NATO. And then, of course, this changed totally with the full-scale invasion of Ukraine. And since then, things really moved very quickly. I also remember I talked with Ulf Kristersson, he was then the in opposition at this Folk og Forsvar conference, and I started to talk to other Nordic, also Swedish and Finnish politicians about the possibility of applying for membership, and then the decisions were taken, and we had very broad support from the whole political spectrum, both in Finland and Sweden, that made this impossible, made this possible. And this is, of course, great, and it demonstrates also that NATO's door is open. It's for NATO allies and the applicant country to decide. It's not for Russia to decide which path different European countries wants to choose. And now Sweden and Finland has chosen to be a member of NATO, and I very much welcome that.
We'll go to DPA here, please.
Ansgar, the German press agency, DPA. Prime Minister, is Sweden open to participating in NATO's nuclear sharing arrangements? And if not, why is Sweden not ready to do it? And a question to the SecGen. Are there already plans to have NATO bases, a NATO, perhaps a NATO headquarters in Sweden? Thank you.
Well, first of all, Sweden, when we become members today or a few days ago, we embrace NATO in its whole capabilities. I think you normally use a 360 degree perspective in a NATO way of putting it. So we don't have any hesitations when it comes to that. We fully understand the need for all of NATO's defense capabilities, including the nuclear strategy. On the other hand, we say clearly that we see no need for Sweden to host permanent bases or nuclear weapons on Swedish soil peacetime. That is a Swedish decision that I find fully respected.
It is, as the Prime Minister said, it's a Swedish decision. There are no plans to expand the number of countries, NATO allies, with nuclear weapons. Then, of course, we are constantly assessing our posture when it comes to conventional forces. But there are no plans for instance, a battle group in Sweden, as we have in the Baltic countries. I think what you need to realize is that the fact that now Sweden and Finland are full members of the alliance is good for the whole of NATO, but it's in particular good and important for the Nordic region and the Baltic region. Because we have for a long time been focused on the vulnerabilities and the challenges to reinforce our presence in the Baltic region, in the Baltic countries. But of course, with both Finland and Sweden into the alliance, the geography really changes, because we now have two important allies, then also on the west side of the Baltic Sea. And we are exercising, we are preparing, we will have plans, of course, to protect Finland and Sweden, but also to help even in a more efficient and stronger way to protect all the Baltic regions. But there are no plans for any permanent bases. And anyway, this is a Swedish decision to be taken if that's something they will consider in the future.
We'll go to the TT News Agency of Sweden here.
Yes, question to both of you. Russia has for many years promised to react whenever Sweden, if ever Sweden becomes a member of NATO. How worried should we now be for cyber attacks, hybrid threats, etc.? And then maybe a word in Scandinavian. Norrmän vinner Vasaloppet, Norrmän vinner Melodifestivalen, en norrman tar Sverige in i NATO, är det dags att återupprätta unionen nu?
Well, concerning Russia, I think we should stay alert. Stay exactly as alert as we are. They are doing all the things you mentioned. I'm quite sure they will continue doing that. We should not be naive, and I think we are more aware of the risks that they pose to us now than we have ever been before. So simply still stay alert. And when it comes to your second question, nej, men vi har ju haft otroligt fint samarbete, det ska jag ju säga, under den här perioden, men också känt ett väldigt starkt stöd också från inte bara norrmän i NATO utan från Norge. Jag hade samtal, första hälsningen kom från Jonas Garstöre och Alexander Stubb som gemensamt besökte NATO-övning i norra i norra Norge i torsdags. Det tyckte jag var fantastiskt fint. Jag pratade med Sauli Niinistö på vägen hit som avgick häromdagen men som också framförde sina hälsningar. Så att jag har känt ett otroligt starkt stöd från. Och nu är vi återigen en gemensam försvarsunion i hela Norden. Det är helt unikt.
Of course, NATO allies always have to be prepared, and we have to be vigilant when it comes to potential Russian cyber attacks, hybrid attacks, attempt to coerce countries in Europe. But we have seen that against both NATO allies and non-NATO allies. So the risk, for instance, for cyber attacks against Sweden is nothing new. That has been a permanent risk for years, also when Sweden was outside NATO. We don't see any imminent military threat against any NATO ally, partly because Russia is so preoccupied with the war aggression against Ukraine, but also, of course, because NATO is there. So NATO is there to make it absolutely sure that any potential adversary understands that attack on one ally will trigger a response on the whole alliance. And the purpose of that is to not provoke a conflict, but to prevent the war, to preserve peace. And NATO has done that successfully for 75 years, even during the coldest period of the Cold War, prevent war, preserve peace, by removing any room for miscalculation or misunderstanding in Moscow about our readiness to protect and defend all allies. So Sweden is safer inside NATO than outside NATO. NATO is stronger with Sweden in as a full ally than Sweden as a close partner. So this is a good day for Sweden, a good day for NATO, and a good day for security and stability across Europe. Then just briefly on the last question. Also, first of all, first of all, det en stor dag for NATO, men ikke minst for det nordiske samarbeidet. Dette første gang siden Kalmarunionen i middelalderen, 1300-1400-tallet, der de nordiske landene har et felles forsvar. Og det en stor styrke for Norden, at vi kan samarbeide dypt om militære kapasiteter, om å forsvare hverandre, om å samarbeide. Og det også derfor en styrke for NATO. Når det gjelder Melodi, Grand Prix og Vasaloppet, så har ikke NATO noen mening om det.
Dagens Nyheter, in front of me here, please.
Well, for Mr. Stoltenberg, Norway's closest neighbor joining NATO, can you be more specific? What do you expect from Sweden as member of the alliance?
So I expect that Sweden will be a very committed NATO ally, and I have all reason to believe that Sweden will be a committed NATO ally, because Sweden has demonstrated in so many different international organizations throughout its history that Sweden is committed to multilateral international cooperation. Sweden believes in the idea of allies and countries working together in the UN, in the EU, and now also in NATO. I also believe that Sweden will contribute to our collective defense, partly because Sweden has high-end, first-class military capabilities. I've had the honor of meeting Swedish soldiers training in Sweden. I've seen the Swedish Navy, and we know also the high quality of the Swedish defense industry. All of this is something that Sweden then brings to the alliance, and we welcome that. Let me also say that I welcome the fact that Sweden has, over the last years, significantly increased defense spending. So now Sweden spends more than 2% of GDP on defense. This is what we need in a more dangerous world, because Sweden, as Norway, as most NATO allies, reduced significantly defense spending after the end of the Cold War, because then tensions went down. But now, when tensions are going up, we need to invest again, and that's exactly what NATO allies are doing, and Sweden is now part of that, and I welcome increased Swedish defense spending.
Final question to NZZ on my far left here, please.
Yes, thank you. Secretary General, on Ukraine, will Ukraine, as the potential 33rd member state, receive an invitation at the July summit, an invitation for accession negotiations? And secondly, on Taurus missiles, if we can all agree that Taurus missiles can well change the situation at the front, do you agree that Germany should transfer them as soon as possible? Thank you.
So Ukraine will become a NATO ally. The question is not if, but when. And Ukraine is now closer to membership than ever before. And this also demonstrates the big strategic mistake President Putin made when he invaded Ukraine. because, as you remember, his purpose was to deny Ukraine to move towards NATO and EU, but also he demanded that NATO should make a declaration, actually sign a treaty with Russia, that there should be no further NATO enlargement with any country in Europe. And now he has gotten, he has received the exact or the exact opposite. He wanted less NATO. He's getting more NATO, more NATO military presence in the eastern part of our alliance. Finland and Sweden are full members, and Ukraine is closer to NATO membership than ever before. And we are continuing to move Ukraine closer to NATO membership by ensuring that their forces are fully interoperable with NATO, by deepening our political cooperation in something called the NATO-Ukraine Council. And I welcome the strong efforts by NATO allies to help Ukraine to come ever even closer to NATO membership. Then on the Taurus missiles, what I can say is, first of all, that Germany has been one of the NATO allies that has provided the most support to Ukraine. Significant, substantial military support from Germany to Ukraine. Advanced air defense systems, IRIS-T, Patriots and others. Battle tanks, the Leopard battle tanks. Significant amounts of ammunition and also a lot of maintenance and repair facilities to help Ukraine develop their own defense industry. So Germany is really a lead nation when it comes to military support to Ukraine. Then I also welcome that several allies are now also delivering long-range systems. UK has been delivering the Storm Shadow, the cruise missiles, France, similar cruise missiles, Scalp, and many allies are now together in a coalition helping Ukraine to train pilots, preparing them for receiving F-16s. So allies are delivering also long-range systems to help Ukraine defend themselves. We have to remember what this is. This is a war aggression by Russia against Ukraine, and Ukraine has enshrined in the UN Charter the right to defend themselves, and we have the right to help them to uphold the right for self-defense. But I will not go into specific systems for specific allies. I just welcome that allies are doing more, including that Germany is providing significant support to Ukraine.
That's all we have time for. Thank you very much.
Thanks. Thank you. Okay.
Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, the Secretary General, the Crown Princess, the Prime Minister of the Kingdom of Sweden, and the official Swedish delegation will now take their places. Excellences, Mesdames et Messieurs, le Secrétaire Général, la Princesse Héritière, le Premier Ministre du Royaume de Suède et la délégation officielle suédoise vont maintenant prendre place. The ceremony will begin with an address by the Secretary General. La cérémonie va débuter par des remarques du Secrétaire Général.
Your Royal Highness, Crown Princess Victoria, Prime Minister Ulf Kristersson, Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen. This is an historic day. We welcome Sweden into NATO at a critical time for our shared security. In a moment, we will raise the Swedish flag here at the NATO headquarters and across the whole alliance for the first time. 32 flags flying together. They represent 32 nations working for a common purpose. To protect 1 billion people, prevent war, and preserve peace. Sweden's membership makes NATO stronger, Sweden safer, and all of us more secure. Sweden brings high-end capabilities, first-class military forces and spends more than 2% of GDP on defense. Sweden's accession shows again that NATO's door remains open. No one can close it. Every nation has the right to choose its own path, and we all choose the path of freedom and democracy. The brave people of Ukraine are fighting for these values as we speak. For 75 years, the transatlantic bond between Europe and North America has ensured our freedom and security. As a friend and a Nordic neighbor, it gives me great pride that Sweden now joins us in this essential mission. Today, as we raise the Swedish flag, we stand together in unity and solidarity, committed to protect and defend each other, all for one and one for all. Prime Minister Kristersson, thank you for your personal commitment to our alliance. Let me also recognize former Prime Minister Magdalena Andersson for the critical role you played in applying for NATO membership. And I'm glad that you are both here with ministers and political leaders together with all of us today. This reflects the broad political support for NATO in the Swedish society. So to all Swedes, I say, velkommen til NATO, welcome to NATO.
Thank you so much. Since Thursday last week, Sweden is a proud member of NATO, the most successful organization for peace and security that has ever existed. We are now an ally among allies. After more than 200 years of military non-alignment, this is a historic step, but also a very natural step. We've been preparing for decades and in details for the last 2 years. With this membership, Sweden has come home. Home to the security cooperation of democracies, home to the security cooperation of our good neighbors. Today, I'd like to say thank you to all of our allies. We have chosen you, and you have chosen us. All for one, one for all. We are humble, but we are also proud. We know that the expectations for Sweden are high, and we have high expectations for ourselves. The Swedish flag will now be raised here at the NATO headquarters with a very strong support in our parliament and our people. A symbol of this is the fact that the Swedish delegation here today consists not only by cabinet ministers and the commander-in-chief, but also by Her Royal Highness, the Swedish Crown Princess Victoria, and altogether six national party leaders. In a vibrant democracy, we argue and we debate, but we unite in the long-term protection of our freedom and democracy. Sweden is no stranger to NATO. We joined the Partnership for Peace in 1994, and we have participated in all major NATO operations and in countless exercises since then. The Russian brutal full-scale invasion against Ukraine united Sweden behind the conclusion that a full-fledged NATO membership is the only reasonable choice. As a strong democracy, Sweden will stand up for the values in the Washington Treaty: freedom, democracy, individual liberty, and the rule of law, values that bind us together. Sweden joins NATO because we believe in the importance of collective defense, but we also join NATO to be a security provider from the Baltic Sea to the Black Sea. Throughout our 30 years of partnership, we have demonstrated a strong capacity to act together with NATO. Our territory is located at the crossroads of Northern Europe, and we are ready to do our part all across the Euro-Atlantic area. We bring with us some unique capabilities. Our armed forces are modern and well-trained on land, in air, at sea. They will bolster NATO's capabilities. Now we will integrate even deeper. We will learn and we will teach. Sweden is fully committed to NATO's role in the fight against terrorism, and we bring a long and strong tradition of successful transatlantic cooperation. We know the importance of safeguarding a strong national defense. We are doubling our own defense budget, and since January 1st, Sweden meets the NATO standard of 2% of GDP to defense spending. This is one important element in contributing to NATO security and burden sharing. We also increase the number of conscripts, we strengthen civil defense, and we reintroduce civilian services. In addition, we also will take part in the intensified work on innovation and emerging technologies. Sweden's defense industrial base is an asset with unique technological edge. The interface between civilian technology innovation and military applications has never been more important. Sweden will be a safer country in NATO, and NATO will be a stronger alliance with Sweden in it. By joining NATO, Sweden, like Finland just before us, has exercised our right to freely choose our own security arrangements. That invaluable right is at the core of the European security order, so bravely being defended in Ukrainian battlefields as we meet here in Brussels. Or, as the US President Joe Biden did put it, when Finland joined NATO, he said, Putin wanted a Finlandization of Ukraine, but he got a NATOfication of Finland, and now of Sweden. Sweden not joining NATO is not the end of something, it is a beginning. I look forward to help making the world a safer and freer place together with all of our allies. Thank you so much.
The flag of the Kingdom of Sweden will now be raised while the national anthem is played. It will be raised simultaneously at NATO headquarters, as well as NATO's two strategic commands, ACO headquarters in Mons, Belgium, and ACT headquarters in Norfolk, Virginia. Nous allons à présent procéder au lever du drapeau du Royaume de Suède, au son de l'hymne national. Les couleurs seront levées simultanément au siège de l'OTAN et sur le site des deux commandements stratégiques, l'ACO à Mons en Belgique et l'ACT à Norfolk en Virginie. The NATO hymn will now be played. Et maintenant, place à l'hymne de l'OTAN. This concludes the flag-raising ceremony. We will now have the family portrait. Nous arrivons au terme de la cérémonie. Le moment est venu de faire la photo de groupe.